Hey guys, just wanted to check in tonight to let you know a nice turn of events in the plans here. No, I didn't buy this Honda. I have a family member that this is their third car, and it's just kept here for when mom comes out from Virginia Beach to visit, and she borrows it from my sister. So it's an unused car. This is a 1990 Honda CR-V. Pretty old-fashioned. And it has 103,000 miles. That's very low for a 1990 car. It's actually very nice. Very small body dings. Real small ones. Let me get a light. So the bumper is obviously very faded and black. See, you got one, I'd call this the major ding, even though it's super tiny. That's the only one that's noticeable. Nice patina on all the wheels. Some nice rust marks there, which I kind of like myself. I'm watching Barrett Jackson right now at the moment, actually, too. Next best thing to buying cars is just looking at cars, so I love watching all those auction shows. Let's check out the interior of this thing. Super old-fashioned. I haven't done a thing to it yet. I am borrowing this for free for 4 to 6 to 8 weeks, could even be till April. And see, this is going to totally save me. If we get rid of the CX-5, I'm under no pressure to find my next car. Look at these old-fashioned stuff here. You got window switches on the dash. Isn't that a trip? And the cruise control up here at this little vent. That's a cruise control button. And what's also rare, you have the stick shift for the automatic is up here like a truck. There's nothing down here. I think that's unusual. I don't know. Maybe it's normal for that. And a nice little gauge there, 103,000 miles. This is my big project for the next month, to just basically cherry it out for them in exchange for the borrowing. Gonna vacuum it, might steam clean some carpets, might take out the seats, steam clean all these stains and stuff. And of course, polish the paint, try and get this looking really brand new. It's gonna be a fun little project. So if the CX-5 goes, I'll be driving this thing for days and weeks and months. It's actually gonna be pretty hilarious. But you know what? I drove it home. I was surprised how good it drove, actually. I think it's as fast as the CX-5, as dumb as that sounds. I think it is. It has some cool little features, though. Look at that. From 1990, it even had armrests and stuff like that on the back seats. It has a front armrest, which our Xterra or our CX-5 doesn't have. So it's a real comfortable cruiser. One of the drawbacks is you have no latch system for the child seats, so it's a big pain in the butt putting the belts through the child seats. That's the only drawback to this thing. It also has a pretty big hatch. Let me show you. I think this is a special hatch thing where you have to open the window first before you can open the back. Well, you can't see anything. Let me get you a light. P.S. I'm drinking Ovaltine hot chocolate with Hello Kitty chocolate-filled marshmallows. Just in case anybody's wondering what I'm drinking tonight. Special Santa Barbara mug we got on one of our trips to Santa Barbara long before we had kids. Nice big hatch. Really, I wish they made cars like this these days. This thing is really solid. These are actually very desirable cars because they are rare now, especially with this low mileage. This is worth at least $3,000, if not more, on the private market. But I was pretty pleased with how it drove. It drove really nice. Man, I can't wait to clean this thing up. This engine bay is disgusting. Look at all that dirt. The engine bay is just a solid brown. Completely. This is going to be so fun to clean. You got dirt everywhere. Disgusting dirt. Piles of it and piles of it. So, it's going to be a fun project. Nice little four banger. Relatively clean. They have maintained it a bit. It just got new tires, new brakes. Doesn't look like there's any leaks that I can see. This is actually really good condition. So I'm going to love cleaning this car up. And that will be my next few videos here. Enjoy.